In the previous video, we discussed the simulation of how the battery is first plugged into the motherboard. If you haven't watched the video in part 1, please watch the video here first. Because this is a continuation of the video part 1. When the battery is installed and on the VIN line, there is already a voltage of 11.1 volts from the battery. If we plug in the AC adapter, what will happen to the charger block circuit? The one I marked in red is the symbol for DC jack. If the AC adapter socket is plugged into the motherboard, automatically on the DC jack line there will be a voltage of 19 volts. Inline DC jack is connected to fuse pin F1 and capacitor PC1. After PC1 is fully charged, current will flow through fuse PF1 to the VAO line. In the VAO line there are two filter capacitors. Automatically the capacitor will be filled with electric charge from the VAO line. After the capacitor is fully charged, current will flow to the VA1 line. In line VA1 there are two pods, first a diode PD1 and diode PD3. Current flows to the anode pins of the diodes PD1 and PD3. Because the diode can only flow in one direction, then the current from the two anodes will flow to the cathode. With a note, if using ordinary diodes, the voltage will drop to 0.7 volts. But if using special diodes such as Schottky, the voltage will drop around 0.3 volts. If the cathode of PD3 has 18.7 volts, then PR8, PR15, PR18 will also have 18.7 volts. Let's go into more detail PR8. The resistor PR8 is connected to PR9. And the other PR9 pin is connected to ground. If these two resistors are arranged in series, and the pins between PR8 and PR9 are used as voltage outputs, then these two resistors are resistor dividers as a voltage reducer. If PR8 the resistance value is 82.5 kilo ohms, and PR9 the resistance value is 10 kilo ohms, then we can calculate the output voltage of the resistor divider circuit using this formula. If the input voltage is 18.7 volts, the output is 2.022 volts. The voltage at the output of this resistor divider circuit is called AC set underscore EC, where the EC controller or KBC will read this voltage as a reference voltage from the AC adapter via the ADC pin in the EC controller or KBC. Before continuing to watch the video, don't forget to press the subscribe button and press the bell button, so you can get notifications for the latest videos from us. And don't forget to click the like button. Press the subscribe, bell, and like buttons, it really helps this channel so that it can develop more. Because subscribing is free. Let's continue to look at the schematic. Focus on the PR15 with a resistance of 49.9 ohms. A voltage of 18.7 volts from this pin will flow through PR15 and the voltage is still the same. This voltage serves to supply IC charger controller ISL88731C. When the DCIN pin on the ISL88731C IC gets a voltage supply, the internal regulator will start to work. This internal regulator will change the voltage from pin 22 of 18.7 volts to 5 volts. The output of the internal linear regulator exits via the VDDP pin. 5-volt voltage from VDDP will flow through PR11 and will provide supply to the VCC pin on IC ISL88731C. At this time, the ISL88731C charger controller IC has started to work. Let's take another look at the PR18 connected to the PR19. These two resistors are arranged as a resistor divider. The input voltage of 18.7 volts from the PR18 and PR19 divider resistor circuits will come out about 3.2 volts in the schematic. But let's do the manual calculation using the resistor divider formula. If PR18 resistance is 82.5 kΩ, and PR19 resistance is 22 kΩ, if the input voltage is 18.7 volts, then the output of this resistor divider circuit is 3.937 volts. Let's look at the schematic. The charger controller IC ISL88731C at pin 26 VCC has got a 5V supply and pin 2 AC and has a voltage of 3.937 volts. Then the current from AC in flows to the internal comparator. The comparator output will drive the internal MOSFET. If the AC in voltage is greater than 3.2 volts, then the comparator output will be low logic so that the MOSFET is not in an active state. The output of the internal MOSFET with the AC OK pin is connected to PR10, so with this condition AC OK from low to high. The high condition of AC OK if measured using a voltmeter will be at 3.3 volts. High and low signals from AC OK will be read by EC controller or KBC. If the AC is OK, the condition is high, it indicates the AC adapter has been plugged in and the voltage is according to the minimum and maximum limits. If the AC in voltage is less than 3.2 volts, it indicates the AC adapter is not installed or the AC adapter is faulty. If AC in is above 5.5 volts, it indicates AC adapter overvoltage. After we discuss in more detail the electric current that passes through PD3, let's continue discussing the electric current that passes through PD1. Electric current with a voltage of 18.7 volts will flow through PR1. PR1 functions as a shunt resistor so that the current goes to pin 123, source of the P-channel PQ5001 MOSFET. When AC set underscore EC and AC OK, the signal is high. The EC controller will change the D/C-sharp signal from a high condition to a low condition. When D/C-sharp is low, transistor PQ5003 becomes inactive, so that the gate voltage on PQ5001 will come from the resistor divider circuit PR2 and PR7. If the PQ5001 pin source's voltage is 18.7 volts, the gate voltage from the resistor divider becomes 9.35 volts. If the gate voltage is less than the source's voltage, the PQ5003 MOSFET, which was originally non-active, will become active or open. Current from the source's pin can flow to the drain pin of the MOSFET PQ5001. At the same time, when the D/C-sharp signal becomes low, PQ5004 becomes non-active or closed. So the gate pin on the PQ5002 MOSFET will be the same as the source's leg through PR3. Because the gate voltage is the same as the source's voltage on the MOSFET PQ5002, then the MOSFET PQ5002 automatically becomes inactive or closed. In the next video, part 3, we will discuss the battery charging process from the charger block circuit. What if the battery capacity is less than 100%, and how the ISL88731C charger IC and EC controller handle it? Discussion of battery capacity sensors, DC buck charging current sensors, current sensors from adapter to VIN line, SMUS data communication between charger controller ICS, and some IC ISL88731C internal registers. And don't forget to click the like button. Press the subscribe, bell, and like buttons, it really helps this channel so that it can develop more. Because subscribing is free,